Yeah, I think for the women, the meet went, well for the group that we put out there. Rachel King getting two victories was, not a given, like it has maybe last year was something that we assumed would happen, but given how cross-country season went, I thought Rachel competed very well, set the school record in 3K and a really dominating win in the 5K. And then the women's distance medley coming up with what I thought was really a surprise win. Hats off to that group that, competed very, very hard. And, it wasn't just one person that had a great leg. They all really, really ran exceptionally. And, kind of was a, nice catalyst, leading into the men's distance medley as well. And, I'm sure I'll forget people, throughout this interview, but it was, again, we thought we had some good things on the women's side, just some injuries that probably kept us from being a place higher, team-wise. And we have to get better, figure out ways to be ready when it counts. And then on the men's side, it was it's kind of like we did it. A lot of things went very, very right for us. North Dakota State, would not back off. To the bitter end, their guys, even the 5,000, put up a huge fight, and we were fortunate to fend them off and claim what seems to have been, the really elusive title that I think we've been chasing here for at least ever since the SJAC opened. I think, it can't be said enough, the two things that made, a difference besides the student athletes and my coaching staff. The opening of that SJAC and the sporting administration and the vision of the administration to make sure that building got built and, gave us something that, a lot of other schools couldn't offer. Being at home in any sport is helpful, and I think it was very helpful to us this weekend. And then just having the right combination of student athletes, veterans that had been through it before, talented newcomers that delivered when they needed to, Sam Zenner, who rededicated himself to, being the best version of himself that he could be, and it was enough. Kyle Burdick coming back in fifth year. And then lots of other points, the people that maybe sixth, seventh, and eighth that you don't mention, but obviously play a huge role in swing points, like winning the distance medley instead of not, if the 800 doesn't go 1, 2, 3, 4 and maybe it was split in half, we've got a dead heat going to the mile relay again. So I think again for our men, it's something that I think we'll all remember for a long time. Don't know how many more we can possibly win, but we'll cherish this one. When you have a collegiate record, all-time best in the history of the NCAA, it says a lot about the Summit League, and Peyton Otterdahl is a tremendous athlete. And you look at a Chris Nielsen from USD who had a big jump as well, and Zach Anderson, the high jump, and a lot of meet records across the board. And this league's been around for 30-plus years, so it's not, in its infancy by any means. So it's... The level of the Summit League, I'm sure at some point the conferences will be measured against each other, but I would think on the men's side, it's definitely probably a top 10 league right now, and certainly it goes a lot because of the high-end folks that we just talked about there, but our guys on the track, I think, brought a lot to it as well, and just the effort across the board, guys who fought and did what they needed to do, and all those points made a difference. I'm just extremely happy for him. I think in a lot of cases, so many things did go in our favor, whether it's, Sam Zenner electing to, walk away from football and come out for track, Kyle Burdick staying for fifth year, and, just other people that, again, took a chance on a program that hasn't won anything in 27 years. And it's not an easy thing to say. It's also very cool that we got some very, very, a lot of South Dakota kids that were involved in it, local kids that, historically our schools attracted, and that, being Division I or Division II, we continue to attract. And glad to see them a part of it, and glad for all the teammates, too, that weren't able to participate, because I think we do feel like we had to leave some kids off the roster that potentially could have scored. And, to do it at home and have everyone have a chance to experience it was pretty special.